Rockets hit a couple more free throws after that. Houston wins 98-94. Chris Paul was, let's just say he wasn't good in the first half. Really, not too many players shot well in the first half. 0 for 7 from the field, scored just 2 points on free throws, but it did go off in the second half. 18 points, 6 of 12 from the field, and 4 of 6 from 3. And the Rockets are a win away from knocking off the Warriors and going to the NBA Finals. Pooch.
Chris Paul, James Harden, 11 for 40 from the floor. Tim Legler, 4 of 20 shooting threes. Boy, that was ugly. That was a bad YMCA game.
Oh, my goodness. Well, look, the only good thing about that game was it was compelling close,
it was.
Right? A lot of drama.
Yep,
I mean, a lot of tension in the building. But yeah. There were so many bad possessions in this game for both teams. You think about it. It was 28 assists total.
Yeah.
Total.
12
Golden
for the Rockets.
State, on a good night in a regular season, is getting 30-plus on their own.
Wow.
28 total. It was ISO after ISO after ISO. Both ends of the floor. The few times Golden State got motion, they got something good for the most part. They relied heavily on Kevin Durant ISOing in the post.
Mm-hmm.
They were getting empty possessions. But then for me, what it really came down to was how poorly they managed the big possessions in this game, including that play at the end where they can't corral the free throw. And when you don't get that clean, there's 10 seconds on the clock. When Ariza goes to the line, you don't come up with that ball clean. And then you pass the ball before the timeout. Now you got to go the length of the court in 6 seconds with no timeout. So they just did not manage the game well. This, again, a typical symptomatic possession of the Golden State Warriors in the second half. Throw the ball to Kevin Durant and let him ISO with guys standing around. And a team that is so accustomed for their motion and their movement and how difficult they are to guard because of the shooting all over the floor, they became predictable over the last couple of games. And it's really played into Houston's hands defensively. And Chris Paul was great in the second half. And Eric Gordon, they didn't win the game without Eric Gordon because James Harden could not make a shot outside the lane.
Durant was 8 of 22. I'm surprised they didn't run more stuff for Clay because he had a good night. He was shooting the ball well. He just didn't get enough shots.
Completely agree with you. He got hot early in the second half.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sitting there watching the game and I'm saying, wow, we haven't seen this since game one. Mm-hmm. He had 3 quiet games. He's strung together some shots out of the locker room. And if I'm Steve Kerr and I'm Steph Curry, Kevin Durant, I'm saying we've got to get some motion going for Klay Thompson.
Mm-hmm.
Because then even if he's not getting more shots, he draws so much attention when he gets into one of those modes, it's going to lead to a slip for Draymond Green. It's going to lead to a driving angle for somebody because they're staying home with Klay.
Warrior basketball.
Correct, which is what we know them for. You know, Steph gets on these runs. KD, Klay Thompson, maybe the most combustible of all of them when he gets hot. And he didn't get enough shots from that point on in the game. And again, the best word I use to describe their offense, predictable. And that's the one thing I thought was the difference between these two teams. The randomness of their offense because of their passing ability versus a heavy ISO team. I did not think the ISO team could beat a team.
Yeah.
But they're not random anymore. They're predictable. They know where the ball is going to be. Houston's gotten very physical with them, and they've had a hard time operating their offense.
Thompson was 8 of 14 from the floor for the Warriors. But again, Chris Paul, and this is a bit of a headline. He did something to his hamstring late. If that's a tear or a strain, this series could turn on a dime. If it's a cramp, that's the best thing that could happen for the Rockets. So here's the deal. Chris Paul just 2 points in that first half, but here he goes now. It's 49-49 legs, and he starts to feel it.
Yeah, he starts going with this high ball screen, getting switches with the bigs. Here he operates on Curry, and this is just a miracle shot right here. But he got several switches with David West, Looney, where he just went into attack mode as a scorer. Knew Harden wasn't really feeling it, and he took over the game during a stretch in the third quarter that maybe they're down 6 or 8 going into fourth without it.
Now they're down 1, and again, hesitation, you know, the running one-hander goes. Rockets have the lead. Back up by 1. Gets a screen from Capella, and oh my goodness.
Yeah, you know, and Golden State tried on that one to get Draymond Green on him for the screen, but they ran 2 screens, and you still ended up with David West, double clutch 3 out of Chris Paul.
J.J. Watt and Timberlake like it. There's another old man YMC move right there. It's a 6-point lead with 4 to go. Now they have a 1-point lead. This is where he injured his hamstring, the right hamstring. He does not make it to the end of the court. The Warriors have a power play.
Unfortunate for Golden State there. The ball ends up in the hands of Quinn Cook, who only had a couple of shots on the night. Steph Curry was coming open. Cook shot it before he saw Curry. They don't take